Right now on Weekend Recharge, we are live across the Northeast where Jonas is the new benchmark for winter storms. It's the very first storm to dump 2 feet of snow in both Baltimore and New York City. A season's worth of snowfall from one storm in Washington, D.C., Philadelphia, Baltimore, and New York City. And we have you covered all across those areas, but we do want to first start with our Stephanie Abrams right now live in New York City, where Stephanie, we're starting to get some of those more official Central Park totals in. What's the latest from you?
That we are. So let's start with JFK, the biggest snowstorm of all time, 30.5 inches. They upped it from 30.3 inches, so now it's 30 and a half inches. Central Park, our biggest snowfall of all time, 26.9, set back in February 2009. We missed it by a tenth of an inch, 26.8 inches. They just put out the official reading that that's going to be it, but people are out here enjoying it. Let me show you the scene here and what we have going on. We have a guy over here with his dog getting his snowshoes ready. We got the kids bundled up, and there you go. The booties for the salt. I did was mentioning that on air and put it on my social media, but thanks for the reminder. It's not good for the animal's paws to be walking through all of that salt, so you want to make sure that you put the booties on them so that they don't hurt their paws. But people are out. People are running. This over here, you can see the streets are actually doing really well. It's just getting on the sidewalk because there's so much snow here in Central Park. Look at the mounds of it that are around. So we're going to swing you back around this way and show you that there's huge piles here in Central Park. And also, yesterday, if you look at the buildings, remember yesterday, you couldn't even see the tops of the buildings. Now, beautiful blue skies overhead. Our temperatures are going to be in the 30s. And you can actually enjoy the snow because it's not too frigid out here. Let me show you the streets as I make my way through all this snow. And also show you this stuff. It's not packable. See, it's really fluffy, so it's going to be really good for all the sledding that's going to be going on. And by the way, there are certain rules in certain parks that you have to wear a helmet or you're not allowed to sled at all. So make sure you check those rules or find a good hill and be careful when you're sledding, guys. Stay away from the trees, just as a reminder. But look at this. Let me take you out to the roads. You know, everyone loves to complain for some reason in our society these days. Can we give props to the government for putting the travel ban in effect? Because look at this. The streets, they are ready to go. Yes, there's a little water on it. Obviously, you're not going to have it, you know, completely dry, but there's no snow. The major arteries here in New York City, you can drive on them. The stores are opening. The sidewalks are looking good. Now, are those small little arteries going to be maybe a little more snow covered? Yes. You know, I mean, it's not a perfect thing here, but they did a phenomenal job. And actually, Cantori, it turned out to be a really fun thing that they had the travel ban. At first, everyone was kind of like moaning about it. But you literally saw people on these huge, you know, Madison Avenue, Fifth Avenue, West Side Highway, playing right in the snow, dogs running about. It turned into like a really fun thing, you know? So always try to find the silver lining in every event. Don't start moaning about it. It's like, did, oh, we can go play Abrams in the streets of New York City. How often do you get to do that?
Abrams, did you see the shot from Times Square last night with all the people down there? And it was kind of dark because of the snow coming down heavy. And I mean, they're just everywhere down on Times Square. You couldn't even read all the signs because the snow is coming down so hard.
Yeah,
it was just awesome. Hey, guys, check this out. Even when you do get back out and around today, which we still don't recommend because there's a lot of cleanup, look at what you're going to have to deal with. I'm just going to walk back here across Louisiana. Look at the sun glint. Ouch. How are you going to judge how far the guy is in front of you? All right, I mean, just real high reflection off of fresh snow or fresh scrape here, guys, that we typically see. Hey, the other thing is, as good as this looks in terms of scraped, here's the deal, all right? Here's the edge of the snowpack right here. Let me show you where the edge of Louisiana is. Right here, 12 feet away. Grab you a cup of coffee. Let's get into the stats, baby. All right, ProSib, let's chuck these up here. Louise, take these full. You can see what we're talking about. Oh, we love to look at all the data in through here. Top five snowstorms for Washington, D.C. This one was number 4 at 17.8 inches of snow. Not bad. Not bad, even though at 7 a.m. yesterday we had 14 on the ground and it puked snow all afternoon. Dulles International Airport, 29.3 inches, number 2. You had to get over 32.4 to get to the number 1 spot. Baltimore, the big winner here. Our friends up the road a piece in beautiful Baltimore getting a big snow there at 29.2 inches. That was number 1 all time. Look at the, here's a great graph. Look at the seasonal average on the right. That's the seasonal average of snowfall. And look at what we got out of Jonas, Blizzard 2016, Snowzilla, whatever you want to call this thing. Obviously, we crushed what we would normally get in a season in all of these areas. And last but not least, talk about a great stat. Great job. Hat tip, Catherine Prosiv, on this one. We have more snow right now in Washington, D.C., at Dulles, than they have in Anchorage, Alaska. But when you look at the average seasonal snowfalls, Anchorage is far and above what they get here in Washington, D.C. Some great stats for you guys to think about this morning as we continue to dig out. Enjoy the dig. Enjoy a beautiful day here, Maria. I'm telling you right now, I just wish that I was doing first track somewhere. It is so beautiful out right now. I don't even need a hat on. It's gorgeous. Get the dome all... I mean, it's just beautiful.
You deserve a first track run with the day in the last 2 days.
I really do, actually. Thank you.
But yeah, great advice. I mean, that glare is something else. Jim Cantore, appreciate it. All right, so yeah, we're talking about just all these superlatives about Jonas, but look at it from space, right? A thing of beauty. This was taken Friday morning, and you can see the city lights as well. Let's give you that quick recap, because it is another one of those wow moments. We take you back to Thursday, 6 a.m., where we're just starting to see the hint of everything coming together, and there you go. You had torrential rain across the south. Then the heavy snow kicked in for Nashville, Lexington, Louisville, up into West Virginia. Wow. And then finally, here we are this morning. You had the clear skies. You saw Steph and Jim's shots. Lots of sunshine, lots of sun glare too. That snowfall, yeah, it got all the way to the south. In fact, all 47 of the lower 48 had some snowpack to report. And then part of that, of course, thanks to Jonas. But look at that deep pink shade from West Virginia into Pennsylvania, Virginia, Maryland, all reporting more than 2 feet of snow. All right, we want to get a check on our other headlines. I'm Winterstorm Jonas, and here's Ana Rodas Rodriguez.
Good morning, Maria. Good morning to you at home. A lot happening as people dig out today. 67 people evacuated just this morning in Manassas, Virginia. Part of a roof caved in from heavy snow at an apartment building outside Washington, D.C. Major East Coast airports are planning limited operations today while crews clear the runways. FlightAware shows more than 3,300 cancellations for today. New York and surrounding communities reopened roads and streets to traffic this morning, and 20 people have died in storm-related incidents. We continue our coverage here on Weekend Recharge. We head live to New Jersey right after your local on the 8s.
I don't want to live with the uncertainties of Hep C.
Or wonder whether I should seek treatment.
I am ready.
Because today, there's Harvoni, a revolutionary treatment for the most common type of chronic hepatitis C. Harvoni is proven to cure up to 99% of patients who've had no prior treatment. It's the one and only cure that's one pill, once a day, for 12 weeks. Certain patients can be cured with just 8 weeks of Harvoni. With Harvoni, there's no interferon, and there are no complex regimens. Tell your doctor if you have other liver or kidney problems, HIV, or other medical conditions, and about all the medicines you take, including herbal supplements. Taking amiodarone with Harvoni may cause a serious slowing of your heart rate. Common side effects of Harvoni may include tiredness, headache, and weakness.
I am ready to put Hep C behind me.
I am ready to be cured.
Are you ready? Ask your Hep C specialist if Harvoni is right for you.
Introducing Centrum Vitamins. A brand new multivitamin you enjoy like a mint, with a full spectrum of essential nutrients. Surprisingly smooth, refreshingly cool.
I see you found the vitamins.
New Centrum Vitamins. A delicious new way to get your multivitamins.
There's a more enjoyable way to get your fiber. Try Philips Fiber Good Gummies Plus Energy Support. It's a new fiber supplement that helps support regularity and includes B vitamins to help convert food to energy.
Mm, these are good.
Nice work, Philips.
The tasty side of fiber from Philips.
Growing up, we were German. We danced in a German dance group. I wore lederhosen. When I first got on Ancestry, I was really surprised that I wasn't finding all of these Germans in my tree. I decided to have my DNA tested through Ancestry DNA. The big surprise was we're not German at all. 52% of my DNA comes from Scotland and Ireland. So I traded in my lederhosen for a kilt.
Ancestry has many paths to discovering your story. Get started for free at Ancestry.com.
We're geeking out on what's happening in weather, how it happens, and why it's so freaking cool.
Weather Underground, weeknights at 6 on the Weather Channel.
Currently in our area, 43 degrees under fair skies. Today, plentiful sunshine, high 56, winds north-northwest at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Tonight, partly cloudy skies, low 49, winds northwest at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Monday, overcast, high 72, winds east-southeast at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Severe weather is I think, when the Weather Channel really shines. You see everyone come together during severe weather events. What it comes down to is that this weather is affecting people. When you start linking the people side up to the weather and the science and the data, it makes a real connection and starts, I think, drive home the importance of what we do.
Welcome back into Weekend Recharge. Traffic is moving again on the Pennsylvania Turnpike this morning. Several jackknife tractor trailers shut down the highway for almost 24 hours, trapping hundreds of motorists.
You're taking a look at a church group from Sioux Falls, South Dakota that got stuck, and they held mass by the side of the road in the snow on Saturday. Quite a few other people who were trapped on the turnpike joined members of Holy Spirit Catholic Church. And what a way to pass the time, because these people were stuck for over a day.
Oh my gosh.
In conditions, I mean, they were helpless out there.
First time I saw that video, gave me chills.
Yeah.
Wow.
Really. Well, the snow was the only concern from Winter Storm Jonas. Flooding turned out to be a major issue for some living near the coast.
Yeah, and a number of flood records set during Superstorm Sandy were broken yesterday, including one for Stone Harbor, New Jersey, and that's where our Reagan Medji is this morning, and she joins us live. And Reagan, I can only imagine floodwater is one thing, but icy floodwater is a whole nother level.
Good morning, ladies. Yeah, and imagine the icy debris then, and you have to wait for it to thaw out. That's what everybody's dealing with. Now, this is a high tide. We're looking on 3rd Avenue in Stone Harbor, New Jersey. For those of you who are familiar, you can see that high tide is taking its impact on the roads here. But what you're seeing right now, cars driving down, that was not happening yesterday. It was just way too high. At this point, we're just looking at not only roads somewhat getting water covered here, but according to Governor Christie's Twitter page, the parkway and the Garden State Parkway and the New Jersey Turnpike, 35-mile-an-hour restriction at this point. Bill Dunston is joining me now, and he is a resident here of Stone Harbor. Temple University, yes. He went there, and you also went with Jim Cantore to his college.
Linden State, Vermont.
All right.
Near and dear to me.
Good. So now, also near and dear to you, Stone Harbor, and yeah. You were out today. What were you looking at?
Well, we're facing three challenges. We're looking at having the water come spill over the bulkheads on the bay side.
Look at her.
And then we also are having challenges with beach erosion.
Mm-hmm.
And we have not had electricity since Friday night. So when you add all three pieces together, it's a significant challenge.
Okay. Now, Bill, when you look at what happened here, and a lot of people, you know, do the comparison to Sandy. What is what happened here yesterday with all the road flooding compared to sanding the damage?
Well, we had the beach erosion with both cases. I would say the water damage, the flooding has been higher, more significant, about 6 inches from what I can tell.
How's your property?
It did come over the bulkhead, and it ran underneath the house. It did not come in the house, but it came very close.
Okay, thanks, Bill. Okay, so we're going to give you another look at the road here, and you can see that the high tide, this is the bay that is flooding into Stone Harbor, New Jersey at this point. Now, coming up in the next half hour, we're going to talk to the mayor of Stone Harbor, basically regarding, you know, she had a conference call with the governor of New Jersey, Chris Christie. He talked about what he saw and experienced yesterday, in addition to the Department of Transportation, about the roads, the head of the state police, about where we are, where we're going, and of course, public utilities. Power's still out here. What's going to happen next? Ladies, back to you.
All right, Reagan Medji, live for us in Stone Harbor. What a story there. Good to see the sunshine, at least. There's that.
High tide was around 8:30 this morning. But when you look at the pictures from yesterday and today, it's good to see that the water is not as high. But let's talk about Winter Storm Jonas, because we were live throughout the entire thing, and our live crews really got beat up at its peak yesterday.
All right, we kind of want to take you into the teeth of the storm.
You need to be off the roads for this storm. I've never been as confident about anything as I am about this one.
Seven to eight inches and counting already.
Some of the computer models suggest another 20 before all is said and done.
We are up over 7.3 feet here in Atlantic City. High tide happened at 6:43 this morning.
We are in the height of the storm right now in New York City, S-plus as we call it. You can't even see the tops of the buildings here in Columbus Circle. It is coming down.
Okay, we're in Stone Harbor, New Jersey. I'm just going to get right to the picture. We're flooded in. We cannot leave our hotel. It's all of the Back Bay flooding. This is the flooding that you're seeing.
It's 2:40, and that really matters if you're in the five boroughs of New York City. Take a look at Times Square right now.
Visibility down to an eighth of a mile. You look down Louisiana Avenue and it's a whiteout. You can only see about two blocks as the snow gets blown by these wind gusts of 30 miles an hour.
Just to give you an idea, conditions have worsened here. We've got a travel ban still in effect. Do want to tell you that New York City is reporting at least 200 crashes, at least 300 vehicles that needed assistance.
And now officially 21.4 inches at Reagan National. It is the second largest snowstorm on record here in the city.
Well, coming up next on Weekend Recharge, we take you live to Charlotte, where our Paul Goodlow will report for us. Coming up.
Andrew. Rita. Sandy. Meet Chris. Jackie. Joe. Minor damage or major disaster. When you need us most, we're there. State Farm. We're a force of nature, too.
What's this?
A box. It takes worn-out things and makes them better.
It's our biggest breakthrough yet. We're taking worn-out batteries and making them into something strong. Energizer Eco Advanced. World's first long-lasting battery made with 4% recycled batteries.
There it is. This is where I met your grandpa. Right under this tree.
Some things are worth holding on to.
They're hugging the tree.
That's why we got a Subaru.
Was it that tree?
The 2016 Subaru Outback. Love, it's what makes a Subaru a Subaru.
I really want there to be a venue where people who are trying to make a difference can have a voice and have a place to talk about their passions. Weather, climate, environment, technology, science. They're the topics of our lives right now. So let's talk about them.
In celebration of Bahamas Paradise Cruise Line's anniversary, we're excited to offer rates from $149 in prime season on our two-night Bahamas cruise. Come experience our delicious food, outstanding service, and the great entertainment throughout the cruise. Get pampered, get excited, and try something new and fun in the beautiful Bahamas. Come celebrate our anniversary. Call 800-814-7100. That's 800-814-7100.
If you had a dollar for every dollar car insurance companies say they'll save you by switching, you'd have like a ton of dollars. But how are they saving you those dollars? A lot of companies might answer, or no comment. Then there's Esurance, born online, raised by technology, and majors in efficiency. So whatever they save, you save. Hassle, time, paperwork, hair tearing out, and yes, especially dollars. That's auto and home insurance for the modern world. Esurance, backed by Allstate. Click or call.
580.
I think what makes the Weather Channel's coverage unique is that we are meteorologists. We know the weather, and that makes a tremendous difference.
Currently in our area, 44 degrees under fair skies. today. Sunny, high 56. Winds north-northwest at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Tonight, partly cloudy skies, low 49. Winds northwest at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Monday, mostly cloudy skies, high 72. Winds east-southeast at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Minutes past the hour. I know all pet owners out there face that challenge, whether the snow or the rain part of Jonas. What to do with the little guy? Look at poor Cooper. Anaritis, you have little teeny dogs.
I love it. He's so cute.
Right? You've got to clean out all the first snowballs, and maybe they might not be willing, but we've got little Cooper here going for it. This sent in by Denise Petrusik out of Columbia, Maryland. And yeah, little Cooper was trying to get out into that winter wonderland. And
going out there because it reminds me of your Cosmo. He just looks outside and he's like, I'm out.
And it's nice they cleared a little path for Cooper to get through and get some stuff done. All right, I want to now take you to Charlotte. Of course, just a little game. NFC Championship kicks off. And my friend, my colleague, my work husband, live for us in Charlotte. Hi, Paul.
Good morning, Maria. And we're here in a very cold Charlotte morning here on this Sunday. NFC Championship hours away, but the good news is you can see a lot of the streets are drying up now with a very strong sun, but on the side roads, also on some of the sidewalks, we still have a lot of frozen muck and mess and ice. The good news is because this is a 6:40 kickoff time, we should see a lot of this melting, and it should be safer for fans to get to the game. The stadium opens at 4 o'clock, half hour early. They're also broadcasting the AFC Championship game, so don't wait at home to the end of that game. Get down here with plenty of time. Make sure you make it safely. You can watch the game inside. And again, a lot of this will be melting as we head throughout the morning. Upper 20s right now. Hey, we're outside, maybe a half block from the stadium and outside the doghouse, where they actually have a radio broadcast throughout the game, pre and post as well. And joining me is Shelley Fassig with WFNZ.
Hey, buddy.
There's a lot of stuff going on here throughout the game. What can people coming down here, if they can't get in the game, what will they get here at the doghouse?
Well, it's going to be a huge day today down here at the WFNZ Coca-Cola Doghouse. We open at noon. There'll be plenty of food. We have hot dog vendors, barbecue, pizza, lots to do for all families. It's free to the public, so we want everyone to come down. Like I said, all ages, bring your kids. Coca-Cola will be here. They'll have a big football toss game. We've got cornhole going on. Lots of samples. Dunkin' Donuts is going to be here with some hot chocolate and coffee. So come on down. It is a beautiful day, and the Panthers are going to have a huge win, so we want you to come down with us, and we start broadcasting our radio show at 4 o'clock, so come join us.
All right, thanks, Shelley. And again, great location to kind of get out of the cold after the game, because you see the forecast there. Temperatures will be falling back through the mid-30s and low-30s and below freezing after the game, Maria, so the big concern is the refreeze that will go on after all this starts to melt. There still will be some slick spots as we head on to the overnight period tonight. Better weather, though, as we head on towards next week. We should melt the 3 inches we got here officially in a couple of days. Maria?
All right. Good advice. Good to know. Paul Goodloe in Charlotte for us. Thank you so much. Anaritis?
Maria, so the worst of the winter storm is mostly past us. Out to sea, the story changes from a major weather story to a huge economic story. And here to discuss it, business weather expert Paul Walsh. Good morning to you, Paul. Great to have you. Let's talk about when you see big cities like Washington, D.C., Philadelphia, and New York, a complete ghost town on a Saturday night. It's obvious. This is a big hit on the economy there.
Yeah, for sure, Anaritis. In fact, according to analysis done by Moody's Analytics, a weekend in this area typically generates about $32 billion in economic activity. And I can guarantee you that this weekend, that was probably cut in half. So it's at least a $16 billion hit in terms of the overall economy. And I can tell you also that I'm, as we speak, shoveling my driveway, and I'm one of those people that is not doing anything economic.
You were sharing headlines this morning, one of them being, will a blizzard freeze the U.S. economy for a third year? You said the short answer is no.
That's right. For the overall economy, it won't have an impact. For the regional economy, though, it'll have a significant impact, especially small businesses, restaurants, and folks that have been impacted by the flooding you saw. There more than likely will be at least $500 million of insured losses, and we'll probably see over $1 billion in damage impacts from this storm.
Talking about the flooding and the people who were impacted, especially along the New Jersey coastline, is flood insurance going to be able to help them? We've been seeing the images of all of the mud that's frozen inside their businesses.
Yeah, well, fortunately, Anna Ritas, I think for a lot of folks that live right along the shore, they will have flood insurance. To live on a shore, to get a loan, to have a shore property, typically you have to have flood insurance. For those folks that live farther inland that are impacted by flooding, most don't have flood insurance. So we'll have to see how that goes.
Paul Walsh, business weather expert, thank you so much for your time this morning. Maria, over to you.
Anna Ritas, thank you. Coming up next, live team coverage of Winter Storm Jonas. We have Jim Cantore in D.C., Stephanie Abrams in hard-hit New York City. And, of course, we just spoke with Paul Goodlow in Charlotte. Talking about the impacts being felt today and, yes, what commuters have to deal with tomorrow. We got you covered, whether it's transit or the weather that you'll be facing as you step out the door trying to get back to work and school tomorrow.
Stay per roll.
Sit. Sit.
More sit per roll.
Watch me, watch me. Roll over, roll over, roll over. Whoops.
More who's training who per roll? Bounty is 2 times more absorbent. So one roll of Bounty can last longer than those bargain brands. So you get more life per roll. Bounty, the long-lasting, quicker picker-upper. And try Bounty napkins.
The challenges facing the country never stop. So neither does the U.S. Army. We train, adapt, and get smarter. Every soldier, every unit, every day. Not to keep up with change, but to drive it. Nobody knows what problems tomorrow will bring, but we do know who will solve them.
James drove his RAV4 hybrid into the frozen wilderness. The scent of his jerky attracted a hungry wolf pack behind him. To survive, he had to remain fearless. He would hunt with them and expand their territory. He'd form a bond with a wolf named Acalia, become den mother, and nurse their young. James left in search of his next adventure. How far will you take the all-new RAV4 hybrid? Toyota, let's go places.
We were below the 88th Southern Parallel. We had traveled for over 850 miles. My men driven nearly mad from starvation and frostbite. Today we make history.
Bienvenidos! Welcome to the South Pole!
If you're Dora the Explorer, you explore. It's what you do.
What took you so long?
If you want to save 15% or more on car insurance, you switch to GEICO. It's what you do.
You did it!
Blizzard of 1978, the one moment that made me a weather geek. I mean, I just loved weather. I remember that night hearing all the warnings, oh, blizzard coming, a lot of snow, blah, blah, blah. Looking at my front window, nothing. Go to bed, wake up the next morning, poof, talking close to 2 feet of snow. Wow, I was hooked ever since.
Currently in our area, 44 degrees under fair skies. Today, sunny, high 56, winds north-northwest at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Tonight, partly cloudy skies, low 49, winds northwest at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Monday, mostly cloudy skies, high 72, winds east-southeast at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Closed captioning brought to you by Beltone.
Beltone is conducting a new trial on innovative hearing technology. You will be asked to evaluate a remarkable product that's virtually invisible. Call 1-800-BELTONE.
They're horrible. Don't even come out. I got stuck with a plow truck a couple of times.
This is awesome avenue.
Hopefully it won't take too much longer.
So what we're doing is illegal today?
Pretty sure it's not legal.
Pretty sure it's not legal.
So it's not legal.
Pretty sure. I think we're sure that's not legal. Those are just some of the incredible sights and sounds from Winter Storm Jonas. Welcome back to Weekend Recharge. I'm Maria LaRosa.
And I'm Anna Reddis. So that you guys Jonas proving to be a benchmark storm for the Northeast and a number of other places across the South. So we break down the numbers for you, Maria. I mean, the two-footer club and above.
Yeah, we're in the 3-foot plus here from West Virginia. We have Sefferstown, West Virginia with 40.5. You know, I've got my 7-year-old who's probably about 43 inches. So, you know, kid level.
And New York, the snowiest storm of all time. They all get members-only jackets.
Yeah, and there's the last 48 hours, and you see it wind up. Just spread at its, you know, peak, and then now offshore. Love this, because Station Commander Kelly was tweeting each pass what Jonas was up to. And we have a little bit of sort of this before and after. You're by the before, so yesterday, and you can see the I-95 corridor with the lights.
That's
the city
incredible.
Lights, right?
And then that's the after. He even caught a glimpse of a thunder snow from space, which was just, you know,
amazing.
Catnip around here at the Weather Channel. Right. But let's talk about who's out there live still covering for us. Our Jim Cantore is out in Washington, D.C., but we begin with Stephanie Abrams this morning because, of course, with all of this snow, public services are slowly starting to come back online today.
It's not even a slow process, A-Rod. I mean, they've got it down here in New York City by shutting down and doing that travel advisory yesterday. The city is so clean. Let's talk more about public transportation with Kevin Ortiz with the MTA and NYC Transit. Kevin, thanks for joining us this morning. You know, I walked up to Columbus Circle from the west side. I've never seen roads looking so spectacular ever. So let's talk about the buses and the trains here. Are the buses going to be able to easily get around the city? I'm assuming so, because it seems like they're clear. Okay, so we've lost Kevin. All right, change of plans. Welcome to live TV. So here's how it's going to play out. I'm going to show you around because that's what we can do here and show you how actually nice it looks. Now, my cameraman, the sun is like blaring right now, so it's gonna kinda make the shot not look perfect, but I'm gonna show you anyway what's happening here because that's how I am. I just try to keep it as it is. So you can see, look at this, the sidewalk's totally fine. This is a huge point where a lot of trains come together on the west side of New York City. And they have made a total clearing right here, no problems whatsoever. How about as we take you into the streets? Let me run over here. We can take you over the streets. Oh, Kevin Ortiz apparently is joining us now. But as I show you the streets, we're going to go to Kevin now with the MTA because, Kevin, I'm just showing everyone live on TV right now how phenomenal the streets are. Making that, you know, travel ban was just epic in order to get the city up and running. But let's talk about the buses and the trains. I'm assuming the buses are all going to be up and running, as will be the trains today. Is that correct?
We've resumed bus service as of 7 o'clock this morning, although that's being done incrementally. We're ramping up service, hoping to bring service to about 80% of a normal Sunday by about 4 o'clock this afternoon.
So tell us about shutting down the city. That really saved you guys in getting the city back up and running, I'm assuming. You were able to do all your work and keep everything moving.
Correct. So in terms of subways, what we were able to do is we were able to run trains below ground where the snow really didn't impact our system. While we were able to use our equipment, our snow blowers, de-icers, and jet throwers to clear snow and ice from tracks on the above ground portion of the system while it was shut down. And as of 9 o'clock this morning, we were able to resume service on the majority of those above ground lines, with some exceptions in Brooklyn.
That's phenomenal. Do you foresee, because this went so well and things are running so great, do you foresee that they'll take action like this sooner and faster with other storms in the future because this has been such a great outcome?
Well, you know, it's really all done on a case-by-case basis, obviously. But we planned ahead, and we knew that if we were going to get the snow that was initially reported, the best thing to do was, at minimum, shut down those above-ground portions of the system.
All right, well, all I have to say is that you guys did a phenomenal job, and I want to give major props to you guys because everyone always likes to complain when things don't go right, and I think we need to celebrate you guys today because the city is up and running. But is the city of D.C. up and running? That's the big question. Jim, listen, the airports for the entire Northeast Corridor, it's a struggle.
Oh, hey, I'm sorry, Steph. I was coordinating. I wanted to actually, I'll tell everybody what I was doing. I was talking to the producer back at the Weather Channel to talk a little bit about what the airport authority is doing, the Washington Airport Authority, because we talked to him about 2 hours ago. And essentially today at Dulles, as well as at Reagan National, it is cleanup. It is all cleanup. They've got a two-fold system where they've got the plows like they have in through here, but they also have this brush, which we don't have here. And what the brush will do is allow us to get down to the asphalt. Because if a plane's coming down at about 200 miles an hour on this, it's not stopping. I promise, it's not stopping. So you gotta brush it all the way down to the asphalt. You've gotta get some kind of traction. If you do get out and drive today, make sure you bring your glasses. I'm trying to get between the sun and my cameraman, Mike, here. Is this good, Mike? Look at the glare right there. I mean, how are you gonna know the distance between you and the guy in front of you? They got a lot of cleanup here. As good as this looks, and it is drivable, by the way, we've lost a little bit of Louisiana, both on that side of the road and this one. So here's the edge of the snowbank, okay? Right here. Now I'm gonna walk about 12 feet to where the road actually ends. So all of that is snow that has to be removed. Guys, a quick look at some of the stats. Where did this storm rank? Another El Nino blockbuster, by the way, for the northeastern part of the country. Reagan is at number 4. I doubt they're gonna change it. Dulles, 23.9, number 2. Baltimore, the big winner here, 29.2 at number 1. And there you see Philly at number 4 with 22.4 inches of snow. So this was a big one. Obviously, JFK was also a number 1 in Central Park. Missed it by a tenth of an inch. Oh!
Introducing Centrum Vitamins. A brand new multivitamin you enjoy like a mint, with a full spectrum of essential nutrients. Surprisingly smooth, refreshingly cool.
I see you found the vitamins.
New Centrum Vitamins. A delicious new way to get your multivitamins.
Ram's continued leadership is eye-opening. Like Ram 3500 with the best towing, best torque, the best payload. And Ram 1500 with the best fuel economy. It's no wonder more people are driving Ram trucks than ever before. Guts, glory, Ram.
Get 0% APR financing for 60 months on the 2016 Ram 1500. Hurry to your Ram dealer today.
Olay Total Effects, a skin transformation that rivals the leading department store moisturizer. Revive skin to fight 7 signs of aging. With Olay, you age less, so you can be ageless. Olay, ageless.
I don't want to live with the uncertainties of Hep C.
Or wonder whether I should seek treatment.
I am ready.
Because today, there's Harvoni, a revolutionary treatment for the most common type of chronic hepatitis C. Harvoni is proven to cure up to 99% of patients who've had no prior treatment. It's the one and only cure that's one pill, once a day, for 12 weeks. Certain patients can be cured with just 8 weeks of Harvoni. With Harvoni, there's no interferon, and there are no complex regimens. Tell your doctor if you have other liver or kidney problems, HIV, or other medical conditions, and about all the medicines you take, including herbal supplements. Taking amiodarone with Harvoni may cause a serious slowing of your heart rate. Common side effects of Harvoni may include tiredness, headache, and weakness.
I am ready to put Hep C behind me.
I am ready to be cured.
Are you ready? Ask your Hep C specialist if Harvoni is right for you.
You think you're doing all you can for your heart health, but 9 out of 10 Americans aren't getting enough important omega-3s. Bayer Pro Ultra Omega 3 can help with 2 times the concentration of omega-3s than the leading brand. Love your heart with Bayer Pro Ultra Omega 3.
Currently in our area, 46 degrees under fair skies. Today, sunny, high 56. Winds north-northwest at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Tonight, partly cloudy skies, low 49. Winds northwest at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Monday, mostly cloudy skies, high 72. Winds east-southeast at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Hey, check this out. Did you ever wonder, what does it look like from a dog's point of view? Well, here you go. Rick Shriver in Delaware put a camera on one of his 3 hounds, and then he released the hounds. And then they, in turn, well, Hank and Owen and Daisy Luce in a snowy yard, and they had fun all over the place, all documented by that little camera there on the hounds. Definitely a day that was not fit for man nor beast. Certainly man's best friend having a great time. Wow, boy. To have a day like that in the snow, it's fantastic. Hey, here in Charlotte, we're all waiting for the Panthers, not the Hounds, the Panthers to take on the Cardinals later on this afternoon. But the big concern is we had 3 inches of snow compounded by some sleet and some freezing rain. And on top of that, temperatures in the low 20s this morning. So we have a big concern with on the sidewalks and the side streets. A lot of frozen mess out here in ice, so definitely trying to get some of the parking lots clear for the tailgaters, which are already showing up. Again, it's a 6:40 p.m. kickoff time, and the officials here at Bank of America Stadium, they're actually opening the stadium a half hour earlier, and they're also going to show on the big screen the AFC Championship game. So if you have problems getting out of your house, take your time, just get here safely. You can watch the end of the first game here to see who perhaps potentially the winner. Maybe the Patriots or the Panthers could take on the Patriots or Denver Broncos as well. They got the forecast for the game. Temperatures will get to the mid-40s today, so a lot of melting going on. That's great news for setting up tomorrow, but it's tonight when the temperatures fall back below freezing. A lot of ice refreezing and forming, so definitely could be slick as people leave the game this evening. Maria?
All right, Paul. Good low in Charlotte. Thank you so much. You know, there are countless ways your kids can end up in the emergency room during and after a winter storm. In today's edition of Momorology, I want to talk about a few of those simple things that can keep them out of the emergency room. Dr. Brian Canterbury is an ER doctor, and he joins us live from Newton, Massachusetts. Good morning to you, sir. Thank you so much for taking time with us. I'm going to tackle the first one because sometimes, you know, we think shoveling, get the kids out there, it's character building. But is it okay for the young ones, kids, teens, to get out there and do that?
Maria, thank you for having me on. And absolutely, the more active we get our kids, the better it is for us and our kids. As long as they engage in regular physical activity and they're bundled up, protected from the cold, there's no reason they can't be out and shoveling the snow along with the rest of us.
You know, I'm convinced that my boys have some weird thermal thing going on that they can stand outside in the cold forever and not care. But in your professional opinion, should we be limiting the time, how long the kids are outdoors?
Well, we just need to keep an eye on how long our kids are outdoors. They do tend to be a little bit more prone to frostbite because there's a bigger surface area to their skin than us adults. But you remember being back at State College, how much fun it was just running around and being out in the cold and throwing snowballs. Kids are kids. We just have to make sure that they're protected. You can get frostbite in as little as 30 minutes, depending on the cold. And, you know, here in our house with our kids, we always use the Weather Channel app to see what it really feels like, to give us an idea of how long our kids can play outside.
And is it always as easy as just, you know, kind of gauging, asking them every now and then, how you doing? Or are they just going to be like, yeah, we're fine, Mom, because they want to stay outside?
I would check in on them. If you're not outside with them, every 20 or 30 minutes, look for frostbite, check for hypothermia. The more they're sweating, the more likely they are to lose a little bit of heat. Mm-hmm. But if you see cold skin or if they're complaining about a prickling feeling, they're talking about how their noses or their cheeks are numb, or you start to notice color changes in their skin, bluish white, red skin, or they start getting really clumsy.
Yeah.
That might be time to bring them in, a little bit of hot cocoa and warming up next to the fire.
Wow. And real quick, I think one thing that kind of sneaks up on everybody, dehydration, because the air is so dry.
Yeah, the air is very dry this time of year. It's all on the ground. So mm-hmm. I always make sure that our kids have plenty to drink. If they're not coming in every 20, 30 minutes for a little bit of hydration, I make sure that they have hot cocoa ready to go at any time.
Great advice, and I can totally get with that. All right, Brian Canterbury, Dr. Brian Canterbury, ER doctor in Newton, Massachusetts. Thank you so much for your time. Great tips, great information, all things to think about without being sort of, you know, the dream crusher. Get those kids out there. They can do that safely, too. And we leave you with a live picture right now of Times Square. You can see the pavement. Everyone trying to get up and running will help you as well. Coming up after the break.
Momorology brought to you by Milk Life. Start every day with Milk's protein and Milk Life. I am powered by protein. Milk has 8 grams to help give you energy to unleash your potential. Start every day with Milk's protein and Milk Life.
Stress sweat. It can happen anytime to anyone.
Stress sweat is different than ordinary sweat. It smells worse. Get 4 times the protection against stress sweat with Secret Clinical Strength Invisible Solid and Clear Gel.
I thought I married an Italian.
My lineage was the Vecchios and Zuccolis. Through ancestry through the DNA, I found out that I was only 16% Italian.
He was 34% Eastern European. So I went on to Ancestry, soon learned that one of our ancestors we thought was Italian was Eastern European.
This is my ancestor I didn't know about. He looks a little bit like me, yes.
Ancestry has many paths to discovering your story. Get started for free at Ancestry.com.
Zantac heartburn alert! Stop! Nexium can take 24 hours to work. Zantac's different. Zantac rushes relief in as little as 30 minutes. For relief without the wait, try Zantac. No pill relieves heartburn faster.
I love Rudy's smile, so I give him these Milk-Bone brushing chews. It's a treat that's proven to clean as well as a toothbrush to help keep his teeth and gums clean and healthy.
This is my favorite.
Say it with Milk-Bone.
We have a charge. We have a responsibility to provide information to people to help them, help their communities, help their families stay safe, and it matters so much.
When you're on hold, your business is on hold. That's why Comcast Business doesn't leave you there. When you call, a small business expert will answer you in about 30 seconds. No annoying hold music. Just a real person, real fast, whenever you need them. So your business and get back to business. Sounds like my ride's ready.
Don't get stuck on hold. Reach an expert fast. Comcast Business, built for business.
It took dozens of prototypes, hundreds of crash simulations, thousands of hours of painstaking craftsmanship, and an infinite reserve of patience to create a vehicle that looks, drives, and thinks like nothing else on the road. The all-new GLC, the SUV the world has been waiting for.
Visit Mercedes-Benz of North Palm Beach today, between PGA Boulevard and North Lake on alternate A1A. Tom.
Currently in our area, 46 degrees under fair skies. Today, sunny, high 56, winds north-northwest at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Tonight, partly cloudy skies, low 49, winds northwest at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Monday, mostly cloudy skies, high 72, winds east-southeast at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
The travel ban has been lifted.
About 12 minutes before the top of the hour right now, New York Governor Andrew Cuomo updating the situation in New York City. Let's listen in.
The roads are clear for the most part. There are still entrance ramps and exit ramps that are not clear. There are still situations where cars are getting stuck on highways. So let's not misinterpret the travel ban. If it is essential travel, necessary travel, that's one thing. If you do not need to be on the roads, you shouldn't be on the roads, because there still are dangerous spots. There are still spots with black ice. And this is still about getting the emergency crews out there and letting them do their job. And every time a car gets stuck, that actually hurts that. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank New Yorkers for their cooperation and their consideration. I know they were inconvenienced yesterday when I put the travel ban in place. New Yorkers are not accustomed to being constricted. I understand that. I understand that the travel ban was an imposition, and it is not something that I have done often. But the travel ban had two purposes. One was to protect people, just to protect public safety. I was on the roads yesterday morning. The roads were extraordinarily dangerous. People were getting stuck all over the place. So it was literally to protect people. Second, the main goal is to clear the roads and let the emergency crews do their work. When you have traffic on the roads, the plows literally can't do their work. So what the ban did for us was it protected the public and it allowed the crews to actually clean the roads. And I think in retrospect, when you look back, it was the right decision, because we have had success in both areas. This storm was very dangerous. The current estimates are about 19 lives were lost along the eastern seaboard by this storm. Luckily, there are no fatalities that we know of in New York due to the storm. No accident fatalities, et cetera. And that is really saying something, since our area was probably the most populous area that was hit by the storm. And no deaths attributed to the storm. We did unfortunately lose 5 New Yorkers from heart attack related deaths from shoveling snow, which is something I caution people today. If you are old like me, you want to think twice before you go out there and start shoveling. At least that's the excuse I use not to shovel any snow today. But the number of deaths, protecting public safety worked, and we just went through a review of the roads in the entire metropolitan area. You have many roads that are down to blacktop that are that clean. You look at the Long Island Expressway, Northern State Parkway, Van Wyck Expressway. It's the crews really did do their job. And the reason they were able to do their job as well as they did, as quickly as they did, was because you did not have the normal traffic on the roads. That was the purpose of the ban, and I think the ban served its purpose. But I know New Yorkers were inconvenienced, but in true New Yorker spirit, they rose to the occasion. It was also heartwarming to see yesterday how New Yorkers were there and rallied one for the other. I can't tell you how many circumstances I came across where people were out shoveling other people's driveways and walkways, people were out pushing cars, people were helping people across the street. It was just great to see how New Yorkers come together in a beautiful spirit of community. You know, sometimes when things are at their worst, it brings out the best, and I believe that's true about New Yorkers. It's also true about our public servants, who have done amazing work all across the board. This was hard. You have crews out there who have been literally working around the clock under very difficult conditions. You have Department of Sanitation crews, cleanup crews, the police departments in the entire downstate area. The NYPD, Nassau Police, Suffolk Police really have done a great job. The MTA, the Port Authority, has done a phenomenal job. And they all cooperated. One vignette that I'll keep with me. Last year, we had 7 feet of snow in Buffalo. Just to put in for New Yorkers downstate, we had a lot of snow. 7 feet of snow is a lot of snow. 7 feet of snow in Buffalo. And I had called Mayor de Blasio, and he had sent up NYPD and fire department personnel. And I met the fire department personnel in Buffalo. And I said, you know, I want to thank you very much for being here. It is a long ride in a fire truck from New York City to Buffalo. And they said without hesitation, you know, everybody was there for us after 9/11. And we'll never forget that. And when anybody in the state needs help, we're going to be there. On this occasion, we had crews from upstate who were down in New York City. We brought crews from all across upstate to come down with machinery, etc. And I saw them yesterday, and they said the exact reciprocal. They said the New York FDNY was there for us when we needed help, and whatever they need, we're going to be there for them. And that's New York. That's one helping the other. That's at the end of the day, we're one state, upstate helping downstate, we're one community. So it was good to see. We've made a lot of progress, but I don't want people to get complacent. We're not out of the woods yet. It's not done. It's cold out there. It's going to be cold tonight. And there is still a possibility for black ice through the day and tonight, and a refreeze tonight. So far, so good, but we have more work to do. With that, let me turn it over first to Ronnie Hakem, who will give us an update on the train situation, both the subway system and the above-ground trains. Ronnie?
Thank you, Governor. As you had noted, we were forced to suspend some service yesterday in our above-ground subway system. That enabled us to come back online. Men and women worked through the night.
You just listened to some live remarks from Governor Andrew Cuomo, New York Governor Andrew Cuomo, on the travel ban being lifted and thanking the city for really taking heed of the warning and still staying off of the roads and letting emergency crews do their job today to dig out from all of that snow.
And all of those crews, too, coming in. All right, we are going to have much more here on Weekend Recharge as we take you live back to D.C. and Jim Cantore.
There's a place for vacationers who seek more than just a little time off. The ones who choose to go big or stay home.
Come with me now.
Where every amazing, despicable, wizarding adventure reveals moments that are truly epic. This place is made for those who do more than just vacation.
Oh, go with me now.
It's made for those who vacation like they mean it. Universal Orlando Resort.
Getting older shouldn't mean giving up all the things she loves to do. It should just mean, well, finding new ways to do them. Right at Home's professional team thoughtfully selects caregivers to provide help with personal care, housekeeping, and of course, meal preparation.
Oh, that smells so good.
Oh, and it tastes good too.
We can provide the right care right at home.
Over 40, feeling tired, losing muscle and even romantic drive? Man up with Ageless Male. Natural ingredients clinically shown to support energy, promote muscle, and boost free testosterone.
The great thing about Ageless Male is that it works.
Man up with Ageless Male.
Eat up, buddy. You'll get it this time. Yeah.
Okay, not too quick.
Don't let go until I say so.
I got you.
Start strong with the lasting energy of 100% whole grain Quaker oats. And off you go.
Currently in our area, 47 degrees under fair skies. Today, sunny, high 56, winds north-northwest at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Tonight, partly cloudy sky. Monday, mostly cloudy skies. High 72. Winds east-southeast at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Charge right now, Governor Chris Christie of New Jersey speaking. Let's listen in.
In my car, and so that was great. I mean, I want to thank the people of New Jersey for staying off the roads. It was a big storm, 24 to 30 inches up here in the northern part of the state, 12 to 28 inches in the central part of the state, and 12 to 20 inches in South Jersey. So everybody got hit fairly hard. But the good news is that if you drive around the roads today, the folks standing behind me and all the folks that they represent did an extraordinary job in clearing the roads. And
you can travel all across New Jersey today. It's all clear. And you can do that because of the hard work of the men and women standing behind me and the folks who are still out in the roads doing work right now. We're really happy to be able to say that there was only about 100 and so people that were sheltered last night in public shelters in Atlantic, Cape May, Camden counties. Ocean County as well, and we're very happy about that. We also are happy to report that our New Jersey Transit system will be back up and running around noon today, bus, light rail, and rail. We had fewer than 300 accidents and across the entire state, which is a very, very small number, and that's, again, a testimony to the folks staying off the roadways. We had a high yesterday of about 94,000 power outages across the state. We're down to about 25,000 this morning. The bulk of those are in Cape May County, about 18,000 in the Atlantic City Electric area. In those folks, you will have about 90% of them will be restored by the end of the day today. We have about 3,000 up in Bergen County, and we have about 4,000 in central New Jersey. The 4,000 folks in central New Jersey should be restored by the afternoon, this afternoon, and we'll see up in Bergen County. I would assume that'll be the end of the day today as well, although the president of the BPU will be continuing to monitor that very closely and working with the folks in Bergen County to make sure their power gets restored quickly. DEP reports that the high tide this morning was survived very well by the people in Cape May County, only minor to moderate flooding, mostly street flooding. We don't see any significant property damage happening in Cape May County. Folks did have to leave because of lack of power in those barrier islands in places like Sea Isle City, Avalon, Stone Harbor, North Wildwood. So for those folks, they went and sheltered often with friends and family. Some went to local hotels where generators were operating in order to stay warm last night. And we report, happy to report, that there are so far no deaths in New Jersey connected with this storm. For today, I think the most important thing is for everybody to remember, if you go out on the roads, please respect the speed limits. Very important, because there's still going to be places where the roads are slick. It's cold. We still may have some icing in places. We're working on continuing to salt in those areas, but there still may be some slick spots. So please be careful. Take your time as you drive around today, but you're free to go out and do what you want to do. Go to church, go to the supermarket, go to some of your kids' sporting events if they've got hockey games or basketball games today. Go out and do that stuff. If those games are on, you should go out there and do it. If you don't have to be out, there's no reason to go out. And so there'll be plenty of stuff, I'm sure, for you to do around the house, cleaning up on a foot and a half to 2.5 feet of snow that have landed all across the state. Last thing is this. I feel very, very fortunate to have the folks that are in my cabinet, the Lieutenant Governor, and all the folks who work for the state of New Jersey, who have worked so hard over the last 96 hours to get us ready for this storm and to carry us through it. It's our 17th snow emergency in my 6 years as governor. So we know how to do this. And when you lead in a strong and direct way, as all the folks standing with me did for their departments, you get things done, and you get things done very well. So for all the people in New Jersey, thank you for your support over the last 24 hours in particular and staying home. And we look forward to a normal, regular work week starting tomorrow. So any questions, I'm happy to take them. Excellent. No questions. I'm out of here.
And you are listening to New Jersey Governor Chris Christie update everyone on the situation in his state. He mentioned at peak about 90,000 without power, less than a third of that at this point this morning, and also mentioning about 100 people seeking shelter along the shore counties, Cape May, Atlantic, and Ocean County, because of some of the flooding, which he says right now is obviously getting much better. And that, if you have things to do out and about, that you should. The roadways are in good shape, but also suggesting that if you don't have to, don't. There's going to be plenty to do with a cleanup of a foot and a half to 2 feet plus of snow. So there you go, New Jersey Governor Chris Christie. All right, want to head up I-95 to New York City, and our Stephanie Abrams is there live. And Stephanie, also sort of the governor of New York saying the same thing, you know, just give it a little bit more time, but life will get back to normal soon.
You know, Maria, I'm having a little bit of trouble hearing you, so I'm just going to take it and do the live shot. So I apologize if you ask me a question, but let's talk about numbers here real fast. And if you look at our yardstick, we had here in Central Park 26.8, so just up to about here, the second biggest snowfall of all time. We missed breaking the record by 0.2 inches, 26.9 is our record snowfall for Central Park. JFK, the biggest snowfall of all time, with 30.5 inches. Now, I feel like it's rude to wear sunglasses on live TV, but I'm wearing them to make a point. We have albedo, okay? And that's the reflectivity. When the sun comes down, let me show you the blue skies. If you were with us yesterday, you couldn't even see the tops of the buildings. Look at that. There is a plane, though, taking off. That's impressive within itself. But the blue skies, thanks to a high pressure. This high pressure is doing a couple things. It's bringing us a lot of sunshine. So as you look over here into that snowpack, it is going to bounce off the snow right up into your eyes. So you need to wear the sunglasses. So the high pressure is giving us clear skies. It's also giving us warmer temperatures today into the 30s, and we are going to warm up into the 40s as we head later this week. How are the roads doing? They're doing great here. Here's a look at Columbus Circle. Now, this is a major thoroughfare here, so we are seeing, of course, those streets are great. I mean, totally clear. They did a phenomenal job because we had, you know, that travel ban yesterday. The travel ban was lifted at 7 a.m. The MTA, we just spoke to them. They're about 80% to 90% up and running here. So things are back to normal in the city. People are walking around. They're enjoying it. Stores are opening. But man, to borrow a line from Big Pun the rapper, Jonas, he's not a player, but he crushed a lot. We saw our seasonal snowfall total, not only in places like New York City, but all the way down into Washington, D.C. And that is epic, that in just a matter of a couple days, we literally saw what we get for the entire season. I think I cannot hear anything in my ear right now, so what I'm going to do is send it back to you guys in the studio because I have no idea how much time we have left to commercial break, and I don't want to get cut off. Back to you guys.
Stephanie, thank you so much for that live report. We're going to continue to check in with you throughout the morning, and also Jim Cantore in Washington, D.C. We're back.
Can't afford to let heartburn get in the way? Try Nexium 24 Hour, now the number one selling brand for frequent heartburn. Get complete protection with the new leader in frequent heartburn. That's Nexium level protection.
No matter what nasty cold symptoms you get, Alka-Seltzer Plus liquid gels rush liquid fast relief to your tough cold symptoms. And they outsell Mucinex liquid gels 2-to-1. Alka-Seltzer Plus liquid gels.
This winter, whatever you step on outside of your car is sure to find its way inside. From Chicago to Seattle, nothing protects your vehicle's floor better than WeatherTech floor liners. They're laser measured to perfectly protect your vehicle. So whether you're playing on the beaches in Florida or even going through the drive-thru out in the bay, for the ultimate protection, choose WeatherTech floor liners. Order at WeatherTech.com or call 1-800-CAR-MATS. Complete protection, completely American made. WeatherTech.
There it is. This is where I met your grandpa. Right under this tree.
Some things are worth holding on to.
They're hugging the tree.
That's why we got a Subaru.
Was it that tree?
The 2016 Subaru Outback. Love, it's what makes a Subaru a Subaru.
The Columbus Community Players present Freedom. Oh, freedom, did we concoct you, or did you give birth to us? Without capture, do you cease to exist? Or are you an illusion here to take the soul hostage for an infinite ransom? I don't know. But Safe Auto has car insurance for about $3 a day. Freedom returns to ride again. Find your freedom at safeauto.com.
We're geeking out on what's happening in weather, how it happens, and why it's so freaking cool.
Weather Underground, weeknights at 6 on the Weather Channel.
Currently in our area, 47 degrees under fair skies. Today, sunny, high 56, winds north-northwest at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Tonight, partly cloudy skies, low 49, winds northwest at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Monday, mostly cloudy skies, high 72, winds east-southeast at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
We know you have a morning routine. We have one too. 7 days a week, AMHQ is right here and weather ready with Jim Cantore, Stephanie Abrams, Jen Carfagno, and the rest of AMHQ.
Let's get right to what you want, and that is the weather.
AMHQ, every morning starting at 5 on the Weather Channel.
And good morning, everyone. Good Sunday morning. After 17.8 inches of snow here at the mall, we continue to now watch things brighten up quite a bit here this morning as the sun is out in full force. It's actually beautiful. After what I dealt with last year in Boston, it's absolutely beautiful out. Guys, FYI, a week ago today, we were looking at computer models, the European, the GFS, the Canadian, and going, you know, there's a chance. There's a chance. And you know what? It happened. Great lead time. Hey, check this out. Louisiana Avenue snowed up bright. Look at the reflection off of even the scrape here if you can't get it to the ground. But where it is dark, all right, where it is dark, it's already starting to melt a little bit. So remember, radiation absorbed by the black, all right, as a result of the waves, if you will, the color. Black absorbs is a good absorber of long wave radiation. Hey guys, time to geek out here for the last few seconds of this shot. I'm coming up to the camera because I want to see this myself. Catherine Proceed, throw up that visible satellite image. Let's check this out. The storm pulls out, the sun comes out, looks down at the snowpack. So those aren't clouds. That's the extensive snowpack, guys, left behind by whatever you want to call it, the blizzard of 2016, Jonas, Snowzilla, you pick whatever you want to use. But you can see the extensive snowpack of yet another big El Nino seasonal storm that we had with this particular flow. Now, the El Nino didn't cause the storm, but that pattern certainly helped jack this thing up. Ladies, back to you in the studio.
All right. Thank you so much, Jim Cantore. Washington, D.C., another city that's digging out today. Mm-hmm. Dulles and National both closed. And the temperatures, they say, are going, at least the sun is going to help with the melt.
It's going to be huge. And then having on a weekend, you get one extra day before everyone's got to get up and going again.
So we go from snow to coastal flooding because that was another major concern when it comes to winter storm Jonas, especially for those living in New Jersey.
Yeah, we had record floods during Superstorm Sandy. Everyone remembers that. But now we've got some new ones, and especially for Stone Harbor, New Jersey, it's been very difficult. Our Reagan Medji is there live for us this morning. Good morning, Reagan.
Good morning, ladies. Yeah, here in Stone Harbor, New Jersey, we're dealing with the Back Bay flooding. This is high tide is now receding. This is 3rd Avenue in Stone Harbor. We're also dealing with power is still out here in Stone Harbor and many other communities. And then, of course, the cleanup that goes along with the flooding. I'm joined now by Suzanne Walters. She's the mayor of Stone Harbor. So I know that you had a teleconference call with Governor Chris Christie this morning. What did you learn out of that? And, of course, then he had the press conference just moments ago.
Right. Well, it was a lot of the elected officials throughout the state, and the governor was out yesterday and Friday in North Jersey and Central Jersey assessing a lot of the damage. He didn't, unfortunately, get down here to Cape May County, but perhaps in the next couple of days that'll happen. The state police was on the phone call things were much better. People heeded the call not to get on the road, so weren't so many accidents. DOT says all the roads are open now. They do have a decreased speed limit, 35. It'll be going up to 45, but everything's open, so people can get out. But they're asking you to be very careful. There are still icy spots, and there's salting equipment and things like that on the road.
And then what about the power? That's a big one.
And the power is the big one. Of course, Stone Harbor is completely out. We've been watching trucks come up and down the street so far this morning, so we're hoping that we'll be back by midday. There are 18,500 customers, Atlantic City Electric customers, that are still without power, and they're saying by midnight tonight, 90% of them will be back in order. So we're hoping. We do have a shelter open here for people to stay warm, get something warm to eat, but we're hoping nobody has to be sheltered overnight tonight.
Okay, so we are at the Reed at Shelter Haven, and the Reeds is where our crew stayed here at the Weather Channel. They have a generator. The generator didn't work the first night. We were without power as well, so our hearts are out to the people who do not have power. Again, if you are in Stone Harbor, New Jersey, or any of the other surrounding communities, Governor Chris Christie announced that the power should be on by the end of the day. And of course, there are warming shelters. Specifically here in Stone Harbor, New Jersey, there are warming shelters. You can get hot food, hot water, hot coffee. And another thing, the fire chief here in Stone Harbor says, and this is very important for places that are flooded, if the house was underwater at any point, and maybe there's meter underwater, everything's going to start coming on, all the power. The fire department now is looking at the possibility of fire calls. So just keep that in mind that, yeah, the power's going on, but everything has been submerged, okay? So if you have anything submerged, just make sure you watch it. Okay, this is the Back Bay. This is the flooding. It's receding now here on 3rd Avenue between 96th and 97th Streets here in Stone Harbor, New Jersey. Of course, we will be following this throughout the entire day and, of course, showing you the coastal beach erosion in the next half hour. Thanks. Keep tuned.
Direct from our imagination. The all-new Civic from Honda.
Heartburn.
No one burns on my watch. Try Alka-Seltzer Heartburn Relief Chews. They work fast and don't taste chalky.
Amazing.
I have heartburn.
Alka-Seltzer Heartburn Relief Chews. Enjoy the relief.
When I lay in my Tempur-Pedic contour, the next thing I know, it's morning.
With Tempur-Flex, you've got the spring and bounce of a traditional mattress. Then it also adjusts my body.
My cloud feels like somebody's hugging you. How can a bed do that?
This year, change your life with Tempur-Pedic.
Those moments where we're dealing with life-threatening situations, we have a charge, we have a responsibility.
You have purpose. You have to get these people out of harm's way.
I'm telling people on TV the exact same thing that I would tell my family members.
And that's really what we're trying to do here, is to make sure people stay as safe as they can and save lives.
With the pain and swelling of my moderate to severe rheumatoid arthritis, ordinary objects often seemed intimidating.
Doing something simple meant enduring a lot of pain.
If RA is changing your view of everyday things, Orencia may help. Orencia works differently by targeting a source of RA early in the inflammation process. For many, Orencia provides long-term relief of RA symptoms. It's helped new RA patients and those not helped enough by other treatments. Do not take Orencia with another biologic medicine for RA due to an increased risk of serious infection. Serious side effects can occur, including fatal infections. Cases of lymphoma and lung cancer have been reported. Tell your doctor if you're prone to or have any infection like an open sore, the flu, or a history of COPD, a chronic lung disease. Orencia may worsen your COPD. If you're not getting the relief you need, ask your doctor about Orencia. Orencia. See your RA in a different way.
When the weather turns serious, you know, the first thing I'm thinking is, how do I communicate the message very clearly to people so they understand what the risk is and how to get through this?
Currently in our area, 47 degrees under fair skies. Today, sunny, high 56, winds north-northwest at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Tonight, partly cloudy skies, low 49, winds northwest at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Monday, mostly cloudy skies, high 72, winds east-southeast at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Just about 20 minutes past the hour. Love getting all of these amazing pictures in from Winter Storm Jonas. And this is one of them from Martinsburg, Pennsylvania, from Janet Reynolds. You got yourself a whole stack of bird feeders here. And I'm telling you, my sister-in-law posted a video out of New Jersey of her bird feeder, and they were going bonkers. It's like they knew that they needed to load up as something was coming. And you can see there definitely trying to dig through that 2 feet of snow that they got there in Martinsburg, Pennsylvania. So love seeing the animals impacted here. And thank goodness that these guys wore a wool coat. You've got Petersburg, Pennsylvania, Kathy Reynolds Soder, Janet's daughter, Kathy, in fact, sent this picture in from K-Bar K Farm. Didn't seem to be bothered by that 2 feet of snow or so. Love to see their sweet faces, but you got to keep warm, right? And whether you are heading out to pasture there, or maybe you're heading to the big championship game, the NFC championship today. My weekend recharge partner in crime, Paul Goodlow, live in Charlotte for us with the latest on how weather's going to affect that game. Hi, Paul.
Yeah, we're definitely concerned about the animals here, too. We got the Cardinals coming in town, some birds versus the Panthers. And let me tell you, the Panthers are hungry for a victory, and they've also been on ice. Take a look at the streets here. Because the temperature's now in about 34, 33 degrees, they're helping to dry up a lot of the snow and ice that did fall across this area, especially sleet as well. But it's the side streets or perhaps the grassy area sidewalks. Take a look at this. It's still very, very icy. And it's been real slick out here. In fact, to the point, I got to thank our friends at L.L. Bean. They outfit us with these things called stabilizers. It's like almost having chains on your shoes. We're out here next to the doghouse WFNS broadcast from. They're also busy doing the same thing, trying to clear out the ice because the shady areas and temperatures around 21 degrees this morning caused a lot of the snow and ice to freeze solid. So they're getting this ready. Again, the good news is kickoff is at 6:40 and temperatures should be in the 40s this afternoon. And speaking of WFNS, I want to bring in Chris McLean. You do the post game here. Last week, the field had some rain. It was sloppy. The players were complaining. What do you think this field conditions are right now, and is it an advantage for one team or the other?
It was ugly last week. Just ask Pete Carroll. He'll tell you about it. He'll give you a good 5 minutes complaining about the field conditions after the game. They've had the tarp on it all week. I think they plan to take it off around noon. About 6 hours before game time. I still think it's inevitable. We've had a lot of rain. They had a lot of wear and tear. There's a bowl game there, you know, and a couple Panther games in a close little period of time. I think it's inevitable. It's going to be choppy. It's going to be mucky. I think the Panthers like that, though. They're a power football team. You look at the Cardinals, they have the Gazelles on the outside that want to run fast. Well, they got to put those big cleats on. I think it might slow them down a little bit.
All right, so again, forecast for the game. Who's going to win tonight, and who has the weather advantage?
Well, I'm picking the Panthers. I wouldn't be able to survive in this town. Look at that man. He's making sure I'm picking the Panthers. I wouldn't be able to survive in this town, Paul, if I did not. I believe they're going to do it. I think the cold weather, too. I'm on the Weather Channel. I'll do weather for you. Carson Palmer's got a finger problem. Cold weather. A team from Arizona plays in a dome. Yeah. Could be a slight advantage for the Panthers, too.
All right, Chris, thanks for your time here. Stay warm. Get inside. Right, so again, 6:40 kickoff time. They're opening the gates at 4 o'clock, half hour early, to make sure people have plenty of time to get here in case they have a hard time with the weather where they live. Maria?
All right, Paul, in Charlotte Forest. Thank you so much. Anaritis.
We go from North Carolina to Philadelphia, another a city hit hard by Winter Storm Jonas. The Salvation Army is stepping up to help. Joining us now is Bobby Myers, an Emergency Disaster Services Director for the Salvation Army. Good morning, Bobby. We know that in Philadelphia, you got a season's worth of snow in 2 days. I mean, can you talk to us about what it's like navigating through that, and what did you have to help first responders do?
So, anytime you get the amount of snow that we've gotten in the last 36 hours or so, it certainly makes road conditions treacherous in particular. So we're just trying to do our part to help emergency personnel do what they do best in getting the roads clear and getting things back to normal or as close to it in short order. So our support consists in large part for them through the city's Emergency Operations Center, supporting them with meals so that they can do what they do best, as well as providing liaison support there to just be able to step up and help out in any way that we can throughout the duration of the event.
Bobby, I don't have much time left. Quickly, can you tell us what you're doing for the people who live in your community? What kind of services are needed today?
Yeah, certainly. I mean, every day homelessness is an issue in our country, and it just gets magnified when we have times like this with such significant weather. And so we've been doing support through the city's Department of Behavioral Health outreach program to reach out to those homeless communities and provide shelter and lodging to them as well.
Bobby Myers with the Salvation Army out in Philadelphia, thank you so much for your time. We're going to continue our live coverage of Winter Storm Jonas. We were with you before the storm, during the storm, and after the storm. A live look at New York City as crews continue to clear the snow from the roads. We'll have live reports through the morning.
And I turn around and there's three rattlesnakes.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Don't worry, Rob. You're covered.
State Farm agents are there whenever you need them.
Welcome.
How you doing?
Good. How are you? So today you're going to choose a mobile office. Okay. You can choose this Chevy Silverado, which offers built-in 4G LTE Wi-Fi, or you can choose this Ford F-150, which doesn't offer Wi-Fi. But to make up for it, we added a trailer, a satellite antenna, and Dolores.
Hey, fellas.
What? So which one do you want?
I'd pick the Chevy.
Definitely.
Or get this dependable Silverado All-Star Edition with a total value of $7,250. Find new roads at your local Chevy dealer.
What's this?
A box. It takes worn-out things and makes them better.
It's our biggest breakthrough yet. We're taking worn-out batteries and making them into something strong. Energizer Eco Advanced, world's first long-lasting battery made with 4% recycled batteries.
I don't want to live with the uncertainties of Hep C.
Or wonder whether I should seek treatment.
I am ready.
Because today, there's Harvoni, a revolutionary treatment for the most common type of chronic hepatitis C. Harvoni is proven to cure up to 99% of patients who've had no prior treatment. It's the one and only cure that's one pill once a day for 12 weeks. Certain patients can be cured with just 8 weeks of Harvoni. With Harvoni, there's no interferon, and there are no complex regimens. Tell your doctor if you have other liver or kidney problems, HIV, or other medical conditions, and about all the medicines you take, including herbal supplements. Taking amiodarone with Harvoni may cause a serious slowing of your heart rate. Common side effects of Harvoni may include tiredness, headache, and weakness. I am ready to put Hep C behind me.
I am ready to be cured.
Are you ready? Ask your Hep C specialist if Harvoni is right for you.
Stress sweat. It can happen anytime, to anyone.
Stress sweat is different than ordinary sweat. It smells worse. Get 4 times the protection against stress sweat with Secret Clinical Strength Invisible Solid and Clear Gel.
I love Rudy's smile, so I give him these Milk-Bone brushing chews. It's a treat that's proven to clean as well as a toothbrush to help keep his teeth and gums clean and healthy.
This is my favorite.
Say it with Milk-Bone.
I really want there to be a venue where people who are trying to make a difference can have a voice and have a place to talk about their passions. Weather, climate, environment, technology, science. They're the topics of our lives right now. So let's talk about them.
Currently in our area, 47 degrees under fair skies. today, sunny, high 56. Winds north-northwest at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Tonight, partly cloudy skies, low 49. Winds northwest at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Monday, mostly cloudy skies, high 72. Winds east-southeast at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Closed captioning brought to you by Beltone.
Beltone is conducting a new trial on innovative hearing technology. You will be asked to evaluate a remarkable product that's virtually invisible. Call 1-800-BELTONE.
They're horrible. Don't even come out. I got stuck with a plow truck a couple of times.
This is Ocean Avenue.
Hopefully it won't take too much longer.
So what we're doing is illegal today?
Pretty sure it's not legal.
Yeah, you got to run back in for that one.
Oh my goodness, I saw a lot of that yesterday. I would not be inspired to do that whatsoever. But regardless, you got a taste of some of the amazing sights and sounds of the historic winter storm Jonas. We welcome you back to Weekend Recharge. I'm Maria LaRosa.
And I'm Ana Reyes Rodriguez. Jonas proving to be a benchmark storm for the Northeast. You look at those pictures, you think of Boston, right, last year. But this is a 1,000-mile stretch of land that we're talking about impacted by the storm.
Right, when you think benchmark, you think this is going to be in textbooks. You probably have many budding meteorologists inspired by the storm that we just had, who will be a meteorologist in the future. Amazing. Look at these totals. Glengarry, West Virginia, 42 inches.
So impressive.
So impressive. Also in West Virginia, in that 3-foot plus. But look at this satellite imagery over the last 48 hours. You get a hint of the scope.
This storm broke daily records. Mm-hmm. It broke monthly records. Some records were just of the stormiest of all time, the snowiest of all time.
Right. And many, many, many cities. All right. So we love looking at it from space. Station Commander Kelly was going crazy yesterday from the ISS, tweeted that picture out of the storm kind of in progress.
Okay.
And then you have the after with the clearing skies that he took today, and there's that I-95 corridor.
The storm is out to sea now, but people are starting to dig out. We have Jim Cantore. He's live in Washington, D.C., but we begin our coverage with Stephanie Abrams. You've been in New York City. We heard from Governor Andrew Cuomo this hour saying, thankfully, no fatalities across the state. Travel ban lifted, but he's asking people to still be careful out there.
You have to be careful because it's icy out in some locations, but they're doing a great job. This is the entrance to Central Park South. You can see people are bringing their sleds into the park. They're walking their dogs, and it's clear. They're doing great. I'll show you the roads in just a second. And speaking of dogs, it looked like a little pup actually lost one of its shoes. This reminds me, all of a sudden you see just one shoe hanging from a wire, like a telephone wire or something like that. You're like, how'd that shoe get up there? It's like, how did this fall off this little dog? But you need to put these on your dog's feet because the salt, it's not good for their paws, so you have to keep that in mind. But we have a lot of snow. How much snow do we see here? First of all, JFK, 30.5 inches, the biggest snowstorm of all time ever on record for JFK. Here in Central Park, 26.8. The biggest snowstorm for us, 26.9. Can you believe we missed it by 0.2 of an inch, breaking it by 0.2 of an inch? If you're gonna get all the snow, you might as well break the record. That was back in February of 2009. The issue now is the sunshine. Beautiful blue skies. Now, what's happened is a high pressure has come in, giving us the blue skies. So we are going to feel that heat. It's really the perfect day for sledding, but you have albedo, the reflection. The sun's gonna come down and bounce off of that snow right up into your eyes. So you definitely need the sunscreen, something you might not be thinking of right now, and the sunglasses as you head out. Temperatures in the 30s, and by the way, we're gonna warm into the 40s because of that southerly flow in between our high pressure and our next low pressure gives us the warmth. Piles of snow for everyone to play in. This is Central Park. As we take you over to the street, things are looking really good. You guys, watch that cord right there. We really got to I don't want anyone to trip over that. But all of this snow, and then you go over to Columbus Circle, and it's fine. I mean, I walked up here this morning and had no issues on the sidewalks. The problem is getting over, this mound of snow onto some of the sidewalks, but the streets are clear. Obviously, there are some areas. I saw you guys tweeting me from I think it was like Queens, also in Brooklyn. It's not 100% everywhere. But overall, Jim, with that traffic ban, it really helped him out. And Jim, I know you're more of a country fan, but you know, there's this rapper named Big Pun, and he says, "I'm not a player, I just crush a lot." And so that's my theme song for Jonas. He wasn't a player. He, you know, he just came right in. He's like, "I'm coming," and we knew he was coming, so he wasn't playing games. So Jonas, not a player, but man, he crushed a lot.
He really did. I mean, the entire Northeast megalopolis, with the exception of Boston, the corridor from New York to Boston, really absolutely hammered with snowfall and really well advertised. And that's the thing. We knew we had a potential historic storm on our hands. So let's talk about this, because the difference between snow in Dulles and National was pretty interesting. I mean, that can happen, certainly in a given snowstorm. But what's interesting is if you look at the water equivalent between Dulles and National, they're virtually the same snow-to-water ratio. I want to bring in Angela Fritz from the Capital Weather Gang. Angela, you guys kind of broke this a little bit yesterday, got the ball rolling a little bit, talking a little bit about maybe there was something wrong with this 17.8 inches. What's your guys' beef with this?
Yeah, so we started to realize yesterday that maybe the measurements that were being taken at National weren't being done properly. The National Weather Service has very strict guidelines as to how we measure snow for very important reasons. And for number one, the historical region, like Stephanie just said, records can be missed by 0.2 inches. So this is very important to do it properly.
Right.
And so we found out that it wasn't being measured. Snowfall wasn't being measured. Snow depth was being measured. It was being done without a snowboard. Snowboards need to be wiped clean every 6 hours so that you don't get compaction. If you get compaction, your final snow total can be a little bit less than what actually fell. And so that could be what happened at National. However, what will be the final difference when the Weather Service goes back and looks at this? Do I think that it's going to be 25 inches at National? No. Do I think it might be a 1 or 2 inch difference? Yes, but that could be the difference between a number 4 storm and a number 2 storm for us. So we need to start digging into this and see, you know, how many times has this happened? Was Snowmageddon also too low? How many times have they not followed the procedure? We just want to know what's going on.
Should the Weather Service demand more frequent updates in the snow, especially given a high confidence potential historic snowfall?
You know, I think that there's only so much we can expect from these guys, especially in blizzard conditions. And I don't want to say that things weren't difficult out there for any of our observers, because winds are gusting up to 40 miles an hour. Can you imagine trying to get a snow measurement when the wind is gusting to 35 miles an hour? It's already very difficult. However, you and me, we want to know what the snow is on the hour, every hour.
So
we want to know what the snow is, but the observers officially need to wait every 6 hours because we need just a little bit of compaction to happen in order for it to get to be official. So we need to actually
to
wait.
To be mismeasured. Angela, we appreciate that. Guys, here's the deal. I would be shocked if they didn't correct it.
To folks out there whose diabetic nerve pain shoots and burns its way into your day, I hear you. To everyone with this pain that makes ordinary tasks extraordinarily painful, I hear you. Make sure your doctor hears you too. I hear you because I was there when my dad suffered with diabetic nerve pain. If you have diabetes and burning, shooting pain in your feet or hands, don't suffer in silence. Step on up and ask your doctor about diabetic nerve pain. Tell him Cedric sent you.
There's a more enjoyable way to get your fiber. Try Philips Fiber Good Gummies Plus Energy Support. It's a new fiber supplement that helps support regularity and includes B vitamins to help convert food to energy.
Mm, these are good.
Nice work, Philips.
The tasty side of fiber from Philips.
James drove his RAV4 hybrid into the frozen wilderness. The scent of his jerky attracted a hungry wolf pack behind him. To survive, he had to remain fearless. He would hunt with them and expand their territory. He'd form a bond with a wolf named Acalia, become den mother, and nurse their young. James left in search of his next adventure. How far will you take the all-new RAV4 Hybrid? Toyota, let's go places.
Sorry, guys.
How many printouts are you waiting on?
200. You?
I sent 50, but I need 10 sets for my meeting now.
Inside every business, too many people sharing a single printer can lead to big problems.
I thought we had this thing fixed.
Yeah, it doesn't stay fixed, though. That's the problem.
Let Brother customize an office solution to keep everyone's workflow flowing. We'll equip you with durable, high-speed printers so you can get your documents right when you need them, putting reliability at your side.
Somebody spilled coffee in here.
Here in the city, parking is hard to find. Seems like everyone drives. And those who do should switch to GEICO because you could save hundreds on car insurance. Oh, perfect. Valet parking. Hello.
Evening, sir.
Here's the keys. And go easy on the right, mate. Wouldn't mind some of that beef Wellington.
To see how much you could save on car insurance, go to GEICO.com.
Currently in our area, 49 degrees under fair skies. Today, sunny, high 56, winds north-northwest at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Tonight, partly cloudy skies, low 49, winds northwest at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Monday, mostly cloudy skies, high 72, winds east-southeast at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
We love love here at the Weather Channel, and love was in the air in the city of brotherly love in Philadelphia. Yes. Look at this. In the middle of a snowstorm, Jason proposed to his girlfriend Lizzie on Saturday.
It's like I never left you, Maria.
She said yes, and they were embraced by both of their families who traveled to Philly from Scranton for the big event. No word on a wedding date, but we are betting on summertime vows. Mm. And we're also betting that 9 months from now, hospitals are just going to be booming with deliveries.
That's a whole nother story. Yes,
in
yes,
Jonas.
Indeed. So we have that really beautiful side, yeah. Right? Everyone kind of come together there, but then you have, of course, the devastation of what that storm brought, including down the shore. I want to bring in our Reagan Medji, who is live in New Jersey with that side of Jonas. Good morning, Reagan.
Good morning, ladies. Yeah, so we are in Stone Harbor, New Jersey. This is 3rd Avenue. You can see that is covered with water. This is the back bay. The bay is to my back. Okay, back bay. And then we got the ocean that way. It's not the ocean that's flooding. It's the back bay that's flooding. High tide was at 8:27 this morning. Now it's going back. So oddly enough, my cameraman, Matt, so sweet, he said, look, you can see the actual bay receding right here. You can see the water going down. Right now, the fire department, we want to thank the volunteer fire department, 50-member volunteer fire department here in Stone Harbor, men and women. They will still be on the job today. They have not left since Friday evening. They have been pulling all these hours because they have to make sure that everybody's safe. They had to do evacuations yesterday. And now today, the power is still out here in Stone Harbor. It will start coming on by the afternoon. That means everything that's been submerged, meters, washers, dryers, might spark some fires. So they're going to be listening. And also, they're going to be listening for those alarms. So a very busy day here in Stone Harbor. Power will be on by the afternoon. So we're going to be monitoring the situation throughout the day. Ladies, back to you.
Countless ways your kids can end up in the emergency room during and after a winter storm. In today's edition of Momorology, I want to talk about a few of those simple things that can keep them out of the emergency room. Dr. Brian Canterbury is an ER doctor, and he joins us live from Newton, Massachusetts. Good morning to you, sir. Thank you so much for taking time with us. I'm going to tackle the first one because sometimes, you know, we think shoveling, get the kids out there, it's character building. But is it okay for the young ones, kids, teens, to get out there and do that?
Maria, thank you for having me on. And absolutely, the more active we get our kids, the better it is for us and our kids. As long as they engage in regular physical activity and they're bundled up, protected from the cold, there's no reason they can't be out and shoveling the snow along with the rest of us.
You know, I'm convinced that my boys have some weird thermal thing going on that they can stand outside in the cold forever and not care. But in your professional opinion, should we be limiting the time, how long the kids are outdoors?
Well, we just need to keep an eye on how long our kids are outdoors. They do tend to be a little bit more prone to frostbite because there's a bigger surface area to their skin than us adults. But you remember being back at State College, how much fun it was just running around and being out in the cold and throwing snowballs. Kids are kids. We just have to make sure that they're protected. You can get frostbite in as little as 30 minutes, depending on the cold. And, you know, here in our house with our kids, we always use the Weather Channel app to see what it really feels like, mm-hmm. to give us an idea of how long our kids can play outside.
And is it always as easy as just, you know, kind of gauging, asking them every now and then, how you doing? Or are they just going to be like, yeah, we're fine, Mom, because they want to stay outside?
I would check in on them. If you're not outside with them, every 20 or 30 minutes, look for frostbite, check for hypothermia. The more they're sweating, the more likely they are to lose a little bit of heat. Mm-hmm. But if you see cold skin or if they're complaining about a prickling feeling, they're talking about how their noses or their cheeks are numb, or you start to notice color changes in their skin, bluish white, red skin, or they start getting really clumsy.
Yeah.
That might be time to bring them in, a little bit of hot cocoa and warming up next to the fire.
Wow. And real quick, I think one thing that kind of sneaks up on everybody, dehydration, because the air is so dry.
Yeah, the air is very dry this time of year. It's all on the ground. So I always make sure that our kids have plenty to drink. If they're not coming in every 20, 30 minutes for a little bit of hydration, I make sure that they have hot cocoa ready to go at any time.
All right. Well, Jonas is out to sea, but a new snowmaker is on the move. We're going to have the details in your winter weather update right after your local on the 8s.
Momerology brought to you by Milk Life. Start every day with Milk's protein and Milk Life.
Are you powered by protein? We are. Milk has 8 grams to help give you energy to unleash your potential. Start every day with Milk's protein and Milk Life.
I've seen hurricanes, floods, I've seen tornadoes. We give out Duracell batteries after the worst happens. And when the power's out for days, we stay with them. You might say they lost everything, but that's not what I see. I see a different kind of power. I saw it in Ruth, Adam, Tom. It's the power they have inside of them. The power to move forward.
At Duracell, we believe that's the power that never, ever goes out.
Zantac Heartburn Alert! Stop! Nexium can take 24 hours to work. Zantac's different. Zantac rushes relief in as little as 30 minutes. For relief without the wait, try Zantac. No pill relieves heartburn faster.
Sir, can you step aside?
Sir? Come on, you know who I am. Progressive Insurance. I save people an average of over $500 when they switch.
Did you pack your own bags?
Oh, right, the Name Your Price Duel. It shows people policy options to help fit their budget. Crazy that a big shot like me would pack his own bags, right? So, do I have the right to remain handsome? Wait. Uh-oh.
We're geeking out on what's happening in weather, how it happens, and why it's so freaking cool.
Weather Underground, weeknights at 6 on the Weather Channel.
When you're on hold, your business is on hold.
That's why Comcast Business doesn't leave you there. When you call, a small business expert will answer you in about 30 seconds. No annoying hold music. Just a real person, real fast, whenever you need them.
So your business can get back to business. Sounds like my ride's ready.
Don't get stuck on hold. Reach an expert fast. Comcast Business, built for business.
Meet Marvin. Marvin thinks you have to be a brainiac to do your own taxes. So we brought in world-renowned brainiac Dr. S. James Gates Jr. to help him get started.
Marvin, you got a W-2?
Yeah, I do.
You got a finger?
Yes.
Take the finger and press it right here. Yay, you got it.
Yay.
Intuit TurboTax. Taxes done smarter.
Currently in our area, 49 degrees under fair skies. Today, sunny, high 56. Winds north-northwest at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Tonight, partly cloudy skies, low 49. Winds northwest at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Monday, mostly cloudy skies, high 72. Winds east-southeast at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
I know New Yorkers were inconvenienced. But in true New Yorker spirit, they rose to the occasion. It was also heartwarming to see yesterday how New Yorkers were there and rallied one for the other. I can't tell you how many circumstances I came across where people were out shoveling other people's driveways and walkways, people were out pushing cars, people were helping people across the street. It was just great to see how New Yorkers come together in a beautiful spirit of community.
And you have to, right? Especially with such monumental weather conditions. So that is great to hear. That was New York Governor Andrew Cuomo. A lot to contend with in the New York metro area. And I know everyone's thinking already about what you're going to face on Monday because of all this. The good news is it happened on a weekend, so we're sort of getting this one more day buffer. But with that said, even trying to get back and up and running today is very difficult just considering travel. So nationwide, these are the number of cancellations. Over 2,000 nationwide. You've got more than 600 just at JFK, more than 500 at Newark, Philadelphia, more than 300 and just in LaGuardia, approaching 700 cancellations with D.C. Reagan at 421. So obviously that I-95 corridor is going to be playing catch-up big time. All right, so here's the situation as we see it right now. You've got the swirl of the winds with our Jonas well offshore, that area of low pressure. The winds are now more out of the north-northwest. So again, that coastal flooding, not as big of a concern or as impactful as it was yesterday. I mean, we had a full moon on top of everything else, so extra high tides. Right now out the door, Philadelphia into the 20s. Same with New York. You've got Pittsburgh at 17 and 26 degrees right now in D.C. Going through the next few hours, you see from clouds from time to time. It's going to stay cool. You're going to have some sunshine. Remember your shades. That is very difficult to, you know, drive around if you're blinded by all that fresh snow. So Philadelphia, that's you. North of I-80 right here, northern Pennsylvania into New York State, not as much of a problem, right? You did not get any of that snow. But what about the next go around? We already got our eyes on it. Look at the water vapor imagery, and you see some things happening here and up into Canada. We've got another snowmaker. This one is going to be kind of moving in, moving out. By tomorrow, though, it is snow from Minneapolis, Duluth, Grand Isle. Notice on the south side, Chicago, rain showers for you, same as Springfield. So for their Monday morning and afternoon and evening drives, it's going to be a bit tricky. So set your alarm a little extra early so you give yourself plenty of time on the roadways. And it's going to keep going here Monday night through Marquette, Green Bay as well, and then swinging through on Tuesday. Remember, our Great Lakes are still pretty much wide open for business, so we'll have lake effect to talk about as well. We have much more to come here on Weekend Recharge as we continue to take you up and down the coast in the aftermath of Winter Storm Jonas.
This is Joanne. Her long day as a hairstylist starts with shoulder pain when, hey Joanne, wanna trade the all-day relief of 2 Aleve with 6 Tylenol?
Give up my 2 Aleve for 6 Tylenol? No thanks. For me, it's Aleve.
There it is. This is where I met your grandpa. Right under this tree.
Some things are worth holding on to.
They're hugging the tree.
That's why we got a Subaru.
Was it that tree?
The 2016 Subaru Outback. Love, it's what makes a Subaru a Subaru.
Yes, we are twins. When I went on to Ancestry, I just put in the name of my parents and my grandparents. And I was getting all these leaves, and I was going back generation after generation. You start to see documents, and you see signatures of people that you've never met. I mean, you don't know these people, but You feel like you do. You get connected to them. I wish that I could get into a time machine and go back 100 years, 200 years, and just meet these people. Being on Ancestry, it just made me feel like I belonged somewhere.
Discover your story. Start searching for free now at Ancestry.com.
I had my mission, and Maxwell House by my side. Cup after cup they came. And cup after cup, it was good to the last drop. We were tested often. But each Maxwell House blend is selected from 5 different types of beans. So all I tasted was victory.
Maxwell House, good to the last drop.
When it's your job to protect the world's greatest nation, it's your responsibility to solve the world's greatest challenges. This is why we search for the best and brightest, why we train for every eventuality, on land and water, in the air, space, and even cyberspace. We operate in a complex world with one simple mission: win.
We know you have a morning routine. We have one too. 7 days a week, AMHQ is right here and weather ready.
Let me get you ready for the day weather-wise.
We've got a lot going on this morning.
Definitely see what kind of pattern we've had.
So start your morning routine with Jim Cantore, Stephanie Abrams, Jan Carfagna, and the rest of AMHQ.
It is a team here at the Weather Channel and an awesome team at that.
Let's get right to what you want, and that is the weather.
AMHQ, every morning starting at 5 on the Weather Channel.
It is 6 minutes for the top of the hour here on Weekend Recharge. Getting in these great pictures. Look at this. You have a little pole there with the light in Purcellville, Virginia, sent in by Marcy of Leesburg there. You've got 30 inches plus of snow.
You don't know where your pathway is. You don't know where your driveway is. You're going to find a lot of stuff under all of that snow. This is in Johnstown, Pennsylvania. Leah Spangler sent in this picture. It's a suburb of Westmont. 2 feet plus of snow reported in the area. You're going to be digging out that newspaper from under all that snow today.
All right, Philadelphia is definitely digging out under 19 inches of snow. Some northern suburbs saw as much as 30 inches of snow.
Our Dave Malkoff is in Philly today. Good morning to you, Dave. What's it like for people there digging out this morning?
Oh, good morning. We've got a very special thing for you. You're looking live at a DJI Phantom drone, a quadcopter, as we go up. We are going to show you what Philadelphia looks like right now. This is a live view of the Schuylkill River right before it joins the Delaware. If you look to our south and southeast, you will see one of the city's icy reservoirs this morning. Looks like the city put some kind of tarp over that. Beyond that, to the southeast, you will see the Philadelphia Museum of Art. You will see the Philadelphia skyline down there where they received 20 inches of snow. That's over the last few days, 20 inches of snowfall. You're looking at the Strawberry Mansion and Brewery Town neighborhoods. That's where the 20 inches of snow have come down in the past few days. If you're looking for 32 inches of snow, you got to go way north to South Allentown where they got all that. That's a record up there here in Philadelphia. It is the sixth largest snowfall in the city's history. We're going to break with a live view of Philadelphia. We will be right back with more of this coming up on the Weather Channel.
You can't always be there to protect her down the road. Make sure the tire she's riding on will. With the revolutionary Michelin Premier Tire, even when half-worn, it's still safe, thanks to EverGrip technology. The Michelin Premier Tire, safe when new, safe when worn.
I've always been protective of my little sister. But when she got cancer, she was the strong one.
She learned while she needed chemo.
It could weaken my immune system.
But then you found out about Neulasta.
Right.
Neulasta helps reduce infection risk by boosting your white blood cell count, which strengthens your immune system. In a key study, Neulasta reduced the risk of infection from 17% to 1%, a 94% decrease. Neulasta is for certain cancer patients receiving strong chemotherapy. Do not take Neulasta if you're allergic to Neulasta or Neupogen. Ruptured spleen, sometimes fatal, as well as serious lung problems, allergic reactions, kidney injuries, and capillary leak syndrome have occurred. Report abdominal or shoulder tip pain, trouble breathing, allergic reactions, puffiness in face or ankles, change in urine, swelling of stomach area, feeling of fullness, dizziness, or feeling faint to your doctor right away. In patients with sickle cell disorders, serious, sometimes fatal crises can occur. The most common side effect is bone and muscle ache.
Ellie's strong, but she still needs help.
Yeah, I do.
Ask your doctor about Neulasta.
Currently in our area, 50 degrees under fair skies. Today, sunny, high 56, winds north-northwest at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Tonight, partly cloudy sky. Monday, mostly cloudy skies, high 72, winds east-southeast at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.